His name is Robert Delf, but he also goes by Bob the Bug Guy, or Bug Bob. And in crowds like this one, he's very popular. As the associate curator of the Colorado Plateau Museum of Arthropod Biodiversity, Delf is in charge of Northern Arizona University's biology outreach program. Here, he's visiting a Marshall School classroom of second and third graders.
Learning about biodiversity is very important. And the problem with teaching biodiversity is you can just get so much with textbooks. And so part of what I do is this outreach program is talking about biodiversity with using live, exciting arthropods as examples. When I'm talking about arthropods, I'm referring to everything from insects to spiders, other arachnids, centipedes, and millipedes. And when the kids get to see a live animal like this, they pay more attention.
Longtime Marshall teacher Carol Coney says her students have been anticipating Robert Delf's visit and his friends with many legs.
We try and include science in any way that we can and to integrate the subjects as much as possible. And Robert's coming to our classroom provides an opportunity for these children that they probably wouldn't get otherwise. In Flagstaff, we don't have a lot of bugs. So bringing the bugs in is such a special treat for these kiddos because they get to see things, and if they like touch things, that's just really special for them. They don't get to do that.
Coney's students have been learning about the scientific method, so she says she's glad Delf used it in this presentation. One of the experiments involved the Madagascar cockroaches, known for their hissing. Turns out the males hissed louder and longer than the females. Delf says the cockroaches are a favorite of his and the students.
And another thing, too, is they're very durable. So one of these type of specimens, I don't mind the kids actually handling. So if a kid accidentally drops it, these cockroaches are pretty sturdy creatures. They're not going to get harmed. So they're allowed to touch them, pet them, and on some occasions they get to hold them, which kids love.
And cockroaches are part of Robert's message on pest management. Insects play important roles in ecosystems, so he discourages the use of pesticides.
Talk about how cockroaches feed on crumbs and scraps on the floor, and so if you clean your house, if you have a very clean house, you're not going to have a cockroach problem. Parents seem to like that. It's their kids to clean up their rooms. But when I'm talking to older people, too, about pest management, I still, it's kind of the same thing, because you'd be surprised at how many people don't know how cockroaches can adapt to pesticides and how dangerous pesticides can be to people as well as insects.
A 250,000 specimens make up the Colorado Plateau Museum of Arthropod Biodiversity, housed at NAU. And this traveling arthropod show helps promote an appreciation and knowledge of biodiversity.
If we don't teach our students about the importance of biodiversity and what biodiversity offers for a healthy planet, then we have no possibility of really having a meaningful biodiversity conservation program.
And education can help people understand the vital roles of these arthropods, says Delf.
For example, pollinators, bees, you know, without some of these insects, we wouldn't have any of the produce that we have today. So that's an important organism. Ants and earthworms, they turn soil, they do a lot of soil nutrient cycling. Without some of these, we'd have a lot of problems with fungi and bacteria in the soil that are really harmful.
Information on this traveling exhibit and upcoming bug camps for students and teachers is available online.